Are you frustrated trying to attract new customers to your clothing store? Facebook ads can be the solution you've been looking for. In this video, I'll show you how to create high converting Facebook ads that will bring in new customers, boost sales, and help you grow your business. All right, so number four is broad Facebook ads targeting. So this is something we've been teaching since 2020, and for the most part, people are still ignoring the power behind broad targeting. Heck, last week, Facebook even started to suggest people to go broad, so you know eventually this will catch on. But think of this as kind of your like cheat sheet until people actually do catch on. So I want to share with you a story about how we lost customers because of broad targeting. So there's two customers here, very unique in what they do in the sense that their approaches. However, they both are clothing brands. The first one, they had been running ads for quite some time. We decided to jump in, help them out, did their email and SMS, kind of really helped, I would say, transform the whole brand. We took them from 3 to 4 million per year to $10 million working with them in 12 months. The downside here is that this person over here who is listening to other people said, they're doing broad targeting. That's ignorant. They should be doing interest targeting. And so they just got this bug in their ear. And then for months, they just kept telling us, please, can we do interest targeting? And we're like, we can, but the results are gonna go down. And then you're gonna be upset with us because you saw the results go down. Ultimately, it came to our demise about 60 days later and ultimately affected our relationship. We are still friends to this day now. And they have since messaged and said, hey, we're sorry that we came to this conclusion, but you were right. What happened is we lost the relationship, lost a client because we're sticking to our guns that this was the best solution for our clients. And I will tell you that right now in this video, mostly because it really is the best solution for your brand. And we've went to the extent of losing thousands of dollars per month because we believed it was best for the company. And I believe it's best for you. Similar, there was a brand that was spending a lot of money per day. We'll call them brand number two, but they were focused out of Florida and they're focused on like the boho weather, like clothing type. And we told them, look, you should go broad. They said, no, we need to focus on boho type of women. I said, well, we can do that with copy and headlines and we can do that with our website, which I'll talk about all of that here in a second. And they said, no, we want to continue to go interest targeting. Well, their cost per acquisition continued to go up because they wouldn't allow us to go broad. This is where we had a little bit of, I would say we were shy because we didn't want to rock the boat too much because we just lost the client. And this one said, no, continue to do interest targeting and continue to run ads the way that we say to. And what happened? Their cost per acquisition went like skyrocketing during the summer. They had inventory issues. They were over bloated and kind of overspent on the amount of inventory that they had. So all of those factors played into this. We went broad for a little period of time right towards the end, and the cost per acquisition did go down, but not enough to where they had to take over the ads themselves because of the inventory. Now, I tell you that because we should have been bullish and said, hey, look, this is the example of the brand that we work with where we went broad, these are the numbers, and this is what you're doing with interest, and the costs are only gonna continue to rise. Let's go this route, let's try this earlier versus us getting 30, 60 days down the road, and then the cost continuing to rise because we went interest route. Ultimately, again, cost us again, not because of results is necessarily on our end, but mostly because of inventory and because we did too little too late. So those are two examples of clients that I will tell you right now, they get caught in the trap of going interest because it makes sense to go after somebody who's like your brand and interested in your brand. And so you use interest targeting. And then what happens is that audience dies out and then you have to go find a new audience. So you spend so much time in ads manager that you forget that you need to run an actual business. And ultimately it costs those clients as well, time and money. And I don't want you to do that as well. So let me break down why broad is actually better and how it actually works. Broad assumes that you're targeting a mass amount of people or it's that it's open, and it's not the case. You're actually giving Facebook the ability to target as many people as it can who are likely to take action on your ad. The copy, the creative, the messaging, the website, all of those things are how the ad is being shared throughout Facebook, and that is how the targeting is done. Now, you should be caring about a couple of things when this is going on, right? When you're going broad, you should be caring about age, gender, and location. And if you are big enough in a big enough budget and are going internationally, create a different campaign for each country and language. Please do not do this unless you have a large budget. Focus on the country. I do not suggest for you to be a US-based brand trying to break into Australia or a European market and your budget's a couple hundred dollars a day. Please do not do that. You have more than enough audience in your target market in your country. So again, broad will start to make a little bit more sense, especially as we build out the ads in a little bit. But now that you have an idea of targeting ads and really why broad is most important, the rest of the video should be able to be a lot more helpful. So it's time that we jump into one of the areas that most people tend to slack on that cost them a lot of money.
A lot of money.
Before we jump into that though and choose the right creative, I just want to say, howdy, my name's Aaron, and alongside my business partner Christian, we started this company in 2015 to help clothing brands grow and scale online, and we promise to give you our best content for free, so please make sure you subscribe. Okay, so number three here is dynamic creative ads. Let me explain dynamic creative ads for you and how we use them, because I think that's probably the best place to start. So dynamic creative ads are ads where you are able to take the best headlines, the best primary text, the best pieces of creative, and put them into one ad so that you don't have to create multiple post IDs and then hope that you've created the best ad. So Facebook will actually do the work for you. Couple of things as you do dynamic creative ads that we'll talk about when we jump into Ads Manager, but a couple of things here to remember. Number one, go off of a concept, whether it's a fall collection, whether it's your new arrivals, whether it's a new drop, whether it's a capsule, you need to go and focus on a creative collection. And then if you can, even more so, break down into even a category. I would look at this as there is a fall collection that is happening, and inside of that fall collection, I want to test UGC. I want to user generated content for my fall collection, and that would be my dynamic creative ads test. However that UGC works, you would move the winning ad next up. So after you figured out which pieces of UGC work, you could create another ad set and another dynamic creative, and you could find the best piece of UGC from the original one and create three more ideas from it. It's about iteration, and that's how you continue to drop and lower the cost. Again, this will all make a little bit more sense when we jump into Ads Manager and here in just 1 second, but conceptually, we need to really break down what is actually happening on the return on the business so that you have an idea what numbers to focus on. Before we jump into blended return on ad spend and why that should matter more to you than a return on your Facebook ads, I want to share with y'all that if you need a personalized approach, schedule a free strategy session with us while there are spots that are still available. Check out the link in the description down below, and honestly, go now before these spots are gone. So number two, blended return on ad spend. I care about your return on investment when you're just starting out, your ads may be breaking even or even lose a little bit of money. Don't worry, you'll get those ads to be more profitable, but I promise you, if you spend all of your time inside of Ads Manager, as I mentioned earlier, you will have it much harder than other people. Now, I want to make sure that I am making a 4 to 7x return on every investment or every dollar that I spend, which includes the ads, yes, but also email, SMS, postcards, organic marketing, UGC, influencers, etc. My business as a whole cares more about profit and profit alone. There are two brands out there that I've talked to that you should, I guess, pay attention to and jump to either one. So there's a brand out there that I know is posting 3 to 4 times a day on TikTok, going all in and then distributing or disseminating that content on Instagram and YouTube and just putting out a ton of content. They're getting 20, 30,000 people to their site per month. They're getting hundreds of thousands of views, all organically, spending a ton of time on there. Now, there's this other group or this other brand rather that is posting, I would say, 1 to 2 times per week, getting no organic traffic, spending $150, $200 a day on ads. This guy over here, he's getting, I would say, I think they're like $40 cost per purchases. Like with his ads, he's spending, I would say, $10 a day or so, but it's mostly organic. So it's a very low budget, but his cost per purchase, super low here. But a good chunk of his revenue is actually coming from organic. His blended return is like a 6. This guy over here, since they're spending mostly on ads, aren't doing as much. They are doing email and SMS, but they're not doing as much organic traffic. This has completely affected them. They're at a 1.5, 1.2. They're basically not making any money, and they're spending it all on ads to reach the same people. Now, this one does take more time. This one does cost more money. Where is it the perfect match? A mix between the two of them. However, if I had to pick one, I would pick the traffic organically over the paid, because again, your business cares about profit. It does not care how it makes its money. It just needs to be profitable. Ideally, you post 3 times a day and distribute it and disseminate that content on multiple platforms, and you spend the advertising dollars. This brand has potential to be successful. It cannot spend its way out of a problem that it has. It has a reach problem and a competition problem that can be fixed with great organic content. When we're talking about blended return on ad spend, I'm looking at this as how good is your organic, how good is your email, how good is influencers, UGC, everything across the board. If you're anywhere between spending a dollar and making 4 to 7 in return, you're in a great spot. 3 to 4 if you're scaling, 5 to 7 if you're doing something, I would say, that is more conservative and just good business growth month over month. That is the target number that you should be focusing on. All right, so number one is building a successful campaign. I cannot tell you guys enough that all of the rest of this video is very, very important for you to make this campaign successful. If you do not understand blended return, if you do not understand profitability, if you don't understand where to generate revenue and why broad targeting is the lowest cost for you, then building the campaign will not do you any good. I know some of you guys jump to the end of the video and try to just copy exactly how to build a campaign. This will not help you if you don't understand the rest of the video. So go back there and watch that if you haven't. All right, let's jump into Ads Manager and build this campaign. All right, so this is the inside of an Ads Manager account, an account that we've been running for some period of time. Please ignore the bottom of the funnel, middle of the funnel, and middle of funnel lives. These are all only created because they also do live selling. It's a little bit different strategy and setup rather than this scaling campaign, the DCT campaign that we have here. So this is our testing campaign. And honestly, this brand does not have enough of a budget where we'd separate a campaign out. I would love to do post ID campaign and then do a campaign that just DCT. However, this is what we have available. As you can see here, we have multiple versions of the new arrivals. So how would we set this up? I would, instead of actually building it, let me break down the anatomy of what this actually is to work. Now I'll tell you which buttons to push. Go ahead and click create, go ahead and hit continue sales. You want to do manual sales campaign, Vantage Plus shopping, man, maybe we'll get there, but right now it's just not something I would suggest. Label it however you would like. We do this as a broad DCT campaign. You can label it however you would like. Advantage Plus budget, that means that it's a CBO. I'm gonna go back to this campaign here because I think the rest of it will make a little bit more sense since we're already here and it has real numbers. Inside of here, the ad set, this broad right here, let's do last 30 days and I'll pick the best campaign. So this one's 47, 30, this has 11, 66 purchases for $31. Let's look at this. So this is our new arrivals version 13. We went for website purchases, not website and shop, at least as of right now. It eventually will switch to website and shop. That's something 2024 and beyond maybe. Dynamic creative, make sure that this button is turned on. This is what allows you to do what I'm gonna show you here in a second on the ad level. Audience, as you can see, is very broad. It is age, gender, location, 21 to 64 year old women. This exclusion here, do not do this. We are testing something right now. It is not best practices. However, we are doing this because we are really focusing on new customer acquisition because this client has given us a limited budget. And so we really need to make other things in the business and squeeze those things out. For you guys, don't do that. You should run your own business and make your own decisions. And this is not a suggestion I would typically make. We just have to, our hands are a little tied here. So don't do that. Don't exclude anything here. Manual placements, we are running everywhere. I don't know why we're not running on Messenger, maybe it's just not a possibility, but we're running everywhere on here. It will optimize and create the best ads for your business. Then we have here attribution, 7-day click, 1-day view. This is your optimization window, meaning that Facebook is trying to get a purchase within 7 days of somebody clicking and 1 day of somebody viewing. If it happens outside of that, it's probably not going to be tracked as easily. Typically, this is the best option. If that changes, we'll do an updated video. We've been doing some stuff for 1 day click and it's been okay. If you have the budget, maybe something to test out. But if you're at $100, $200 a day, 7 day click, 1 day view, good option for you. Next thing, ads. The button that we clicked was DCT or dynamic creative testing, and that allows us to do multiple image ads into one spot. It allows you to do videos and stuff as well. But what I mentioned early in the video is we want to create by a concept. So what we did here was graphic. This is what we're testing, new arrival graphic. We're testing new arrivals added daily as the text. It's the exact same text, it's the exact same graphic, just different models. Actually, yeah, different model, one different model, and then different backgrounds and colors, figuring out which one actually works. Put on here headlines, shop the latest styles, new arrivals that would turn heads. These are so basic, but I promise you, for whatever reason, we've been testing these two for years against other ones and they continue to work. So copy and use the copy however you like. Description, new arrivals added daily. People love to know that there are new arrivals added. You will see here that these are our new arrivals URL. Make sure that's in there. Tracking is turned on. Offline events will will still be a thing, but we're doing a lot of different things with tracking and may move to some CAPI, which is conversion API. That may change, but basically make sure that you're all green over here on the left-hand side. If you have triple whale, make sure to put in your triple whale UTM. This will allow you to track the actual revenue and sales from this actual ad. If you have a winning ad, I'm looking at purchases. I don't really care about click-through rate. I don't really care about cost per thousand impressions. If I have purchases, I want to look at that. So this one has 41 purchases for $30. This one has 10 for 24. This one right here is likely my winning ad. It's actually the one that has the only different model. So it's a younger model. And that one actually did the best. This second one here had 10 purchases, a little bit older of a model. Crazy enough, whoever is in the ad, if it's a young person, it's going to attract younger people. If it's an older person, it's going to attract older people. That may seem obvious, may not seem obvious, but right here you can see which is the winning ad. It actually has the lowest frequency as well. We spent almost the majority of the money here and great purchases. So this would be a quote unquote winning ad that we would want to move over to a post ID. Again, if we had more budget, we would do that. But worst case, what we would do is just continue to increase the budget 5% a couple of times throughout the week and just slowly start to scale the brand. Now, give context, this is a multi-million dollar a year brand. We do a lot of other things for them. As I mentioned throughout the video, those pieces are needed. These are just the ads for this brand as well. All right, y'all, so if you like this video, then you need to check out our latest video on Instagram ads right here. It's step by step. It's probably one of our most popular videos on how to grow a clothing brand. Go check it out right here. Hope you have a great rest of your day. We will see you in the next video. And P.S., please make sure that you hit that subscribe button.